Hi everybody, everyone's talking about Ruel. He's been the guy since he was a teenager, writing absolutely incredible, catchy pop tunes. And I'm Europop after all, and he's English stroke Australian, the best of both worlds, because when it comes to pure entertainment, they do it best. They really do in the pop world. And I think the rest have to follow. Now, you can comment and like and hate me for that, but I'm telling you, this man is proving that Australia is the place to seek out, with Australian blood, the best pop acts. Okay. Everybody on my channel is amazing. Ruel is a recommendation. And let's be fair, I've been following him for quite a while, but I waited until my channel was growing and growing and got to the point where I could bring him on board. Now it's a really sunny day outside, the light is pouring in, and I feel he's an uplifting singer-songwriter, English stroke Australian. Last FM I went to, and they did this for a bio. The laid-back soulful singer with which Ruel sings his catchy pop tunes, they say, could only be delivered by a true natural. But the British Australian songwriter, born Ruel Vincent van Dyk in 2002, has also been working at it for a sizable chunk of his life. Ruel was on the precipice of his teenage years when his dad sent a demo of him doing a James Bay tune to producer M Phases. And Demi Lovato and Eminem are some of the acts that are linked to that particular person. And in 2015, kickstarting his run as one of the 21st century's pop's foremost purveyors of feels. Imagine, he's been labeled with that earlier on in his career, never mind now. His debut EP, 2018's Ready, proved that he was exactly that. Before ever becoming a legal adult, Ruel built a record packed with well-crafted R&B and inflected chart-ready songs. The breezy rhythm of Dazed and Confused, with the heartbreak that strings and set from the center for the throbbing chorus, making stand out. And Younger, with its sugary vocal hooks, bouncy piano and gospel singers, softens the blow of a story about friends growing apart over time. Now, in 2020, his music continued to mature with Bright Lights, Red Eyes, etc. Using a stream of conscientious writing style, Ruel's bedroom pop vulnerability shines through on songs like The Rousing Courage, creating a tenderness and intimacy that's impressive for an artist of any age. So he's a mature thinker, a mature lyricist. He's a phenomenal performer. And his videos just attract more followers every year. Now, he's attracted me, but again, everybody, when I was looking into this young man, I wanted my channel to be at a stage where it was growing and I was comfortable bringing people like him on board because I wanted to give a quality introduction, and I think I've done that. Now, when it comes to the album itself and what he says about the song, he says this is an up-tempo, really fast and energetic. And I was like, it would be corny if this was happy lyrically. I thought, I want to write an angry song about how much I hate somebody. I'm going to do my own two fingers song. Everyone else has got a two finger song, and I didn't have one. This song went through 70 versions. Imagine that, everyone, to get it right. Now, when I'm doing my videos, the editing and everything takes lots and lots of, it does on my part. To get it right, takes. That's what we'll call it, takes. But 70 versions of a song? I'm really, really intrigued now. I've got the lyrics in front of me, looking forward to it. It is, one of those songs that you just are so involved with, I got told, from the beginning to the end, because it's the video that makes it. So I'm even doubly intrigued. Are you not? I hope all the people around the world that follow my channel, and I do put this video in over 32 languages, will click on their language and enjoy today's guest, Ruel. I Don't Want to Be Like You, track two on his EP, Fourth Wall. Can't say more than that. I hope I've done you justice. Let's get going. I'm looking forward, and I believe it's one of those two-fingered songs. and I'm in the mood for giving two fingers to somebody, somewhere. Ruel, I don't want to be like you. I just want to be like me.
Your smile's like a dark cloud. Can't wait for the fallout. Big joke, but the kids don't get it. Big words, but it's not poetic. Lost touch, trying to save me. No time for it lately. Big sigh, but it's so dramatic. Decipher what you're saying, but I feel like I'm stuck inside of your imagination. Just like this conversation, it's never gonna end. Go fuck yourself and all of your friends. I don't wanna be like you. 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 It's not.
Yeah, cool. Okay, we got it.
Thank you. Well, I have to say, it's a different video. Somebody said it'll catch me by surprise. Oh, it did. It really did. And you know who you are. You're one of the people that recommended Ruel to my channel. I have to say, short, sweet, effective, with a catchy phrase that just resonates with everybody. And I can see everybody singing that. You know, I don't want to be like you. No, I don't want to be like you. And even I was pointing out there, you know, you get with it very quickly. Young man, you certainly do have lots of catchy tunes. And of course it says, verse one, your smile's like a dark cloud, can't wait for the fallout. Big joke, but the kids don't get it. Big words, but it's not poetic. Lost touch, save me. No time for it lately. Big sigh, but it's so dramatic. It's not like I don't care, don't understand. I'm not going to get there holding your hand. Temperature is rising. Watch the sunset. No, I better say this before I forget. This is a young man who obviously has, I'm going to put it this way, somebody very, very close to him. And he's more or less saying, look, there's a big world out there. Before that sunset sets on my life and before I'm gone, I want to make my mark like I have been doing. And I don't want to be like everybody else. I don't want to be thinking like you, that, hey, me and you, let's get serious. Let's get married. Let's have kids. Let's follow the norm. Well, not norm. It's not normal today. Good God, no. But let's do the traditional thing. We'll put it that way. Everyone else is doing it. No, he's like, no, no, I don't want to be like you. And he is pointing the finger at everybody. And when you see the lineup of those men in the car coming and he's solo on the boot, very effective symbolism, because it's basically each person, and it could represent a name or a letter, but it represents, I think, how many times life has hit him hard and run over him, and people have just went and spat at him. And he's like, you know what? People have always walked all over me, and I don't want to be like them. And he's looking around, and those people represented all the people that stood in his way to say, you should, ought to, this is the way things should be. And he's like, nope, I don't want to be like you. And it is something that we need to reflect on, the seriousness of the title, because so many people want to be like somebody that they know or they look at in the magazine and they change their hair and the style and say, that would suit me. And I always say, it won't suit you till you get this sorted, until inside is happy and you're reflecting it on the outside with a smile. People always say to me, I've great cheekbones. And I say, do you know why? I've got great cheekbones, not inherited, well, it is hereditary, sorry, inherited, hereditary, because my mother had fabulous features. But it's the fact that I'm smiling so much. They say, you've great skin. Yeah, I have great skin. I don't have wrinkles because I'm not worrying about everyone else. And you're always in good mood. Yeah, because I don't want to be like everybody else. I just want my personality to shine and be like me. Look, at the amount of people that said, you're going to be a failure if you leave your university job at Trinity College, one of the top colleges in the world, that thousands of students pass through every year. And I said, yes, I'm a worker for one of the most prestigious universities in the world, but I don't want to be like them. I want to be me. I want to be creative. I want to write my books, and I've written them. I'm an author. I do music. I'm so fulfilled. I'm so creative because I didn't want to be like you, big brother, telling me your life should be like this. You work, you get a pension, you retire, you may travel if you're able. I'm able now to travel. I'm able now to be creative. I didn't want to be like them. It's just how my life panned out. And people say, I would like to be like that. And he continues, I don't want to be like you, and repeats it. And in verse 2, he says, I'm trying to be patient, decipher what you're saying, but I feel like I'm stuck inside your imagination. And what he's saying there is basically, when we date somebody, when we're with somebody, or when we have companionship or friendship, whatever term you want to put on a relationship, when somebody's with you and sharing your life, they always try to change you. They do. And they think it's for the better. Well, maybe sometimes it is. I talk a lot. So now, uploading videos for YouTube and doing my music, I get to talk a lot. So I'm quieter in the evenings. So it's still my personality, the world of good, to get out that frustrated, I want to talk. And then my partner has, in his imagination, the ideal CC. And I'm like, no, I don't want to be like you. You go to work, you come home, you go out in your work functions. I'm quite reclusive. I love my dog walking, taking my dog for a walk, sitting with a coffee, chatting to strangers. The ice is broken with my dog. He's the most fabulous looking wee Yorkie. And it breaks the ice with everybody. Cute dog, blah, blah, blah. We talk. I'd felt imprisoned when I was at the university. And before that, I worked with another prestigious university, UCD, that's renowned throughout the world as well. And I just felt I was imprisoned there. This is the first time I've got liberation. Talking to strangers, because everybody who watches the video is a stranger. But I'm not stuck inside my own imagination, feeling this is the way my life's going to go. Now it's how I want it to be. So I can understand that. I'm stuck inside your imagination. And my partner learned to accept, embrace, and say whatever makes you happy. It took a long time, but eventually they were the words I wanted to hear. And now we're both happy. And it continues, just like this conversation is never going to end. Go two fingers yourself and all of your friends. In other words, when you do something, who judges you the most? It's usually your partner, but with their ear bent from talking to friends and them giving them a second opinion instead of them thinking for themselves. So he's right to give the two fingers to everybody who thinks he ought to be like, question mark, she ought to be like, question mark. If you're in a relationship, they ought to be like, question mark. No, no, no. Simple phrase, I don't want to be like yous. Bridge, it's not like I don't care and I don't understand. It's not going to get there holding your hand. Said I got to stay and trust the process. No, I better stay before I forget. So yeah, it's a case of, in a relationship, speaking your mind. That's basically what that's about. And don't be holding my hand thinking, I need to take you away or put you on this road to success or life's happiness or sort out your own happiness. Usually the people that want to make you happy or see you differently is because they're unhappy and they don't see where they're going. And what I say is, if you want yin and yang in your relationship in life, sort yourself out first before you give advice. And then from the hurdles and the struggles, give advice how you got over them and bring in positivity. But if you don't understand, nobody needs anybody holding your hand. It's true. And he finishes, I don't want to be like you. And I say to everybody listening, do you want to be like anybody else? No. My advice, be yourself. I am now, and I'm the happiest I've ever been. And I'm going to, react to Eurovision that's coming up. I always missed it. All those times I was imprisoned in the universities, I miss Eurovision for working. But now I get to react, and I get to smile, and I get to have a laugh and talk to you. I don't want to be like you, but I do want you to join my channel. Subscribe and like and comment. Take care for now. Bye bye. Welcome, Ruel. I have to say, short and sweet video, but I will be definitely reacting to you very, very soon again. Take care.